Live and Zoot with Jatai Academy, and welcome to another educational video in our ongoing series. You know, when we talk about our Healthy Luxury Shaving Set and we start discussing facial hair with our customers, it opens up a world of possibilities. And facial hair shouldn't be an accident. What I mean by that is, and with the popularity of beards, having a beard is not about not shaving. Having a beard is not about just doing nothing and letting nature run its course. Having a beard is a lot of work. Having a beard should be, and a mustache should be, deliberate. And it becomes a question of, what are we trying to accomplish? And the answer is, facial hair and facial hair patterning, mustache shapes and designs, beard thicknesses and width and length, all can be used to create illusions. It's no different than in the ladies' world of makeup, the way in which makeup is used to accentuate or to downplay certain areas of facial shape and contour. We have the magical ability to do many of these same things by customizing facial hair. I'll give you a couple of great examples. In the case of a long face, a customer whose face is longer, if they have the desire to alter the appearance of that, we would be looking for ways to create width. Width would be created, for instance, with a mustache. It breaks up the face vertically, top to bottom, by creating visual impact or interest with a mustache. Same goes for beards, but someone with a long face, I wouldn't encourage a goatee or a long full beard. You know, a lot of these really long beards right now on guys with long faces, they look even longer. If that's the desire, it's a great way to do it. But if that would be considered objectionable or not the aesthetic desire one was searching for, keeping that beard short, close, and groomed in would be a great way of minimizing the appearance of length on a longer face. Another great example is someone with a rounder face shape. With someone with a rounder or fuller face shape, the worst thing you could do is subdivide it horizontally to create a greater impression of width. What would the answer be? The answer would be beard with length. If we've got a beard coming down off of someone's chin, not necessarily as closely groomed, or even within the beard design, short at the sides with a little extra length through the center area is going to create the illusion of width. It's going to pull that facial shape down and narrow that facial contour quite a bit. We also can apply some of the same techniques to hair cutting, but I wanted to specifically address what we do with facial hair. As an example, in the round-faced scenario, in the desire to create length, not only can we create length at the chin with a beard, but by creating height in a haircut, and narrowness through the sides, we further accentuate or exaggerate length. So there's some great ways to apply this creatively. Lastly, I'll mention, you know, the guy with no chin. If a guy doesn't have a chin, where in profile it looks like a light bulb, he's curved down right into his neck, by putting a goatee with a little bit of length and fullness, a mustache and goatee, you break up the vertical side here. I tend to look like a slab right here. I've got a lot of cheek and a lot of face right in through here. My wife doesn't like it, but if I grow a mustache and I grow Fu Manchu or a handlebar mustache, it does a beautiful job of breaking up this large physical area, and I actually look leaner. The problem is I look a little older. The other problem is now it comes in gray. You don't know that, I didn't mention it on this video. But it's a great way of customizing the use of facial hair to create shapes and illusions and different perspectives. It's a fabulous tool. One of my suggestions is go online and download what they call those sketch head sheets that we used to use in beauty and barber school to plan out haircuts. Download some facial silhouettes and just play around with a pencil or a set of markers and see where that same basic face shape, if you add a mustache, how does it alter the appearance of it? What happens if you put a goatee on there? The other thing you can do is flip through a magazine. Take a Sharpie marker in any old magazine. We did this when we were kids, where we started adding mustaches and beards on people in the magazines. Well, now do it with a purpose. Do it with a reason to see, and don't do it with the ladies' magazines. Do it with the men's magazines. Put a mustache on a guy, put a beard on a guy with a pen, and see how it changes the appearance of their face. It's a fabulous educational exercise to open up your mind to the possibilities of how we can use facial hair grooming to really alter the appearance of faces and facial shapes. I'm Ivan Zoom with Jatai Academy. Have some fun with this. Thanks for watching, and have a great day.